What will you do if your daddy raped your mother? If you were half nobility, half brother, you'd invent yourself. Maybe I wasn't mixed. What if I wasn't the product of Sir Jennings Beckwith and his side chick? What if I was a baby crow raided by the Cheyenne, suckled by a mom with 12 other children? So it's no wonder why when they say amen, I'd be like, aight then. Because while my siblings be learning to recite prayers, I write them. God given the gift of gab without the hyphens. Every time they've ever tried to back me into a corner, I boxed them. Pops was white, so I watched him. He ended up being right and unlocked me. Manumissioned. So I was all about my papers. Free to run the Rocky Mountainside, trapping and trading at its foundation. All the fur hustle is fabrication. So whether I am actually the lost son of a crow chief or not is irrelevant if his daughter dates me. Maybe not faithful to all my Indian brides, but as a member of the tribe, I couldn't trade with. American Fur Company, my former employer, got bent out of shape with me. In fact, my former boss, Mr. Bent, would later govern in NM territory and be beheaded in the Taos Revolt, better him than me. By the time I switched sides and abandoned my wife in search of gold mines, became a professional card player in a boom town, and took a black ride this time. But it was a town in California that took my last name, where I told the story of my life. I mean, let's be real. You can't live the lives I've lived and spend all your time reading and writing, so I did what I do best. Spun a whole spool of tale to Tom Bonner in 1855. And wouldn't you know it, The Life and Adventures of James P. Beckwith was published in 1856. Was entitled to half the proceeds, but the judge never paid me a nickel. However, should have never been The Life and Adventures. Should have been The Life and Death. Can't play both sides of a massacre that results in the death of 160 peaceful Cheyenne children, women, and men. Half black, half white, half crow. Half U.S. Army scout, all that pedigree, it's hard to remember me and even harder to figure me out. But if there's one thing I've learned from never belonging to anyone except myself, if all them furs don't keep you warm, the traps sure won't help.